have one more active case in the state of Meghalaya. So now again we have reached 4 active cases in the state of Meghalaya. So we have got 4 active cases, and also we have recovered 42 of them, and the total case already 47 now. Till today the testing has been sent till 26th of June. This is 18,037. Those who have already tested negative till today is 17,741. And we are waiting for the result, which has sent for testing at 250. And those coming from outside till today, the 26th June, is 18,358. Mandala Long Baro, South League active case at that state Meghalaya. Kiblajem, Ilong South Kuarmut. Nanta de total case Baro, Bangidun Meghalaya, Ilong South Kuarmut. Nanta ki number ki ba la ha ek sample mun test ki lo khat prahajar lai kun nyo we pra not mai nyo ki bla test negative adu munda ngasi ar blue blue jun ki lo khat nyo hajar nyo spa sau we we nyo nyo sau we ki bedang up pade ek test adu munda ek report ro mas pa sampo but kaba kibalawan na jabar do nda ki long khatra ja lais pa san pra kita i ba taksi we active case de na po riboy district so 3 kujun na po meghalaya po 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 riboy ke tika sa de wi de ba de no sushno de ba state meghalaya hi te gilat kamo ki te pilani te ko ma ar bana hi chate je po guwahati isa ar bana je te bi 1003 manta bana hi quarantine center ba manta hi Rano Shapo Corona Care Center Mandasi. Oh, Shabram. Kashmir, Napori Boy District. He has come from Guwahati. He had stayed there for 20, for 2 months. He came on the 24th of June. The same day he was sent for testing and it's found tested positive. Since that day they kept him in the quarantine center and now he'll be shifting today only to the Corona Care Center. He is from the Umden village, Riboy district. We long asymptomatic.
We have already discussed in detail about the increasing trend that has happened especially in Guwahati, and I think the day before still we already instructed the entry points and the exit points to be more proactive to make sure that unnecessary visitors should not enter the state of Kerala. Again today we discuss about this issue and we further request even our people from the state of Meghalaya to avoid going down to Guwahati, because the government of Assam today they have come out with the notification that total lockdown will happen from 28th of this month for 2 weeks. So therefore in compliance to the notification that has just come out from the government of Assam, government of Meghalaya is also right now requesting our citizens from the state to kindly avoid or please don't go down to Guwahati except those cases which is unavoidable. That is the message where we would like to appeal to all the citizens of the state. Again, today we had a review meeting at 3 o'clock and a few decisions we taken again. One important decision we taken today is related waiting to for the relaxation to be made by the government. And today, after receiving the inputs from all the concerned deputy commissioners and district administrations in the state of Meghalaya, we decided today that reopening up of hotels, will start from 1st July 2020. 1st July 2020. And protocols and SOPs is right now being issued to all the respective deputy commissioners to take necessary action accordingly. Nadu Kashitri Ubnai July Arto Arto Baku Yakane Ishim Yakarai Hadin Penayo Yaka report the inputs baro na ki deputy commissioners hapo Jogetila Hajomi. But Yaki SOPs, protocols, Nakalian Basurka, Kalapunkre and issue Munda, Siapro deputy commissioners, Bakin Snowha, Banle Yakabadanka. Kakade away Karai Kabayashim, Mentaka Sni, Bakabaar Kumala Kren Menet, Kabaar ke issue Kabi discuss pa Hadin ba ki positive cases ki nakiu hapo Assam. But Kumjuru Nakalian Chok Sorkar Assam, Menet Kilarai, Bandung yang ketutul lockdown apa Guwahati ada nombak kejoki nalu aru prakrit jom kuni ugnai na kenta atayo dan nakalian coba sorka jomi ngila ai ya ke direction lembau chief ketri ba un penmi ya pada lembah jomi district administration ban apil gerbang ya baru kita suruh senang jauh jelah bak kins ngeluhan ban sangat ban lift siapa Guwahati lani siapa Assam like no kitu kikam kibam lakir syu ban katar da ki application ban ka MOC ka ban sahai leng bagi deputy commissioners jom kajelah mikroya jomi. Kata tadi kebentar migrant mana hadir bagi UI yang di case batu melawan UI yang berubah health minister mana UI berkata kata case positif case ke bagi UI meneru nanti dari boy district itu sama udai uba usung jadi sebuah asam lah kumbang arbenai berkabar mendai tak kata mendai tak usung apa asam arbenai yang kuati udai uku nongkit ubahnya kali wakil yang kena kagut man supply good syati syapo asam te adil menyuri yang kena yuki nak ketau nak kalian menjauh surga ka ayam yang kau odat syaporo hidup di komisioners bakin sengoha ba ya kajilet syapa coba jelan kandun biang ke restriction kenan ba kipai ba jomi kenosi nanti siapa. Bat kebalan menen ya keren susu ada isu kebide berketu ke decision yang menasib. The decision that we taken last time relating to the tuition fees, school fees, notification, draft notification has been approved by the government. I think today, if not today, tomorrow positively, notification will come out. And then I would request all of you, you can find out from Education Department the details of the notification. But notification is being prepared. Hopefully tonight or tomorrow it will come out. And second point, not only that, the notification will also come out not only for tuition fees, it will also come out for the private run hostel. Private run hostels, people. Those podium, the hostels, or maybe what they call it, PG, in the form of PG. So that notification also is coming out from education department, and the order is being issued again today. And the order contains the words like this. It contains the wording like this. Proprietors of private owned hostels in the state of Meghalaya are directed to cease and desist from charging rent from students during the period of the lockdown beginning from 1st April 2020 till further orders. The total lockdown happens from the midst of March, but the notification take effective from 1st April 2020 till further orders. Okay? And again, those students who keep staying from 1st April, maybe because of their exams, or maybe because their parents or the family said, no, please don't come back, you stay there. For those people, they have to pay. You get away, they have to pay. Not that they should not pay. Those who are already there, who are already staying there, who does not wish to go back to their respective places, they have to pay. But those people who has to go, means when the lockdown happened, so all of them, they started leaving the hostels, they don't have to pay their fees. And the fees, the notification says that from 1st April, the proprietor should not charge any hostel fees. I wanted to share with you. Relating to the street hawkers, we discuss about this issue because we are also concerned about the livelihood of our poor people who earn their livelihood from these small businesses that they have all along the roadside. For your information, I would like to tell you, we have already constituted, notification was already in place, where we constituted two committees. One committee is under the chairmanship of the CEO, Shillong Municipal Board. And the second committee, headed by the Deputy Commissioner Shillong, or Deputy Commissioner of the respective district, to find out ways and means to make sure that the regulation is in place as far as the street hawkers are concerned. So today we decided in the review meeting, again, we have given the direction to these two committees. One is headed by the CEO Shillong Municipal Board, which falls under the jurisdiction of Municipal Board. And the other one is headed by the Deputy Commissioner outside the Municipal Board to, again, identify immediately the appropriate places for accommodating these poor people so that their livelihood can be restored. So these are the decisions to be taken in the review meeting today. Those requisition orders done by the government, we continue functioning that. That we continue functioning that. But those who are not requisitioned by the government, not requisitioned by the government means reopening up is allowed from 1st of July 2020. It is the bounded duty of those private schools to make sure that the salary of the teachers is regularly picked. It is the boundary. So let me just refer to the Act. There are few acts which is right now applicable in the entire nation, not only in Meghalaya, in the entire nation. One act is, we know, Disaster Management Act 2005. Disaster Management Act 2005. And then number two, Meghalaya School Education Act 1973. So under these two acts, they are bound to pay the salary of a teacher.